he began to pray. Something from God.
Now,
when he began to pray,
Bible made
me understand that. The devil also came there.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Satan began to ask Joshua some questions.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Satan said so many things about Joshua.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now Joshua also for penny dear.
Joshua was a high priest.
Joshua brought good to know when you are when you were not a dear people at one. Never yet at the fin.
But when he went into the presence of God, there was something which was with him, which is the dirty clothes I'm talking about.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Dear brother, was just yes, a war bomb fire.
When he began to pray, devil started remembering him about the things of that dirty clothes. There are a lot of believers in this world. As time goes on, they go into prayer with God. As time goes on, they pray to God. Because of certain things in your lives, prayer will not be answered. As time goes on, you pray. Because of things that is in your life,
the
devil begins to remember you of so many things in your mind.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, Bible says, after Joshua,
Bible says when Joshua began to pray and the devil started remembering him of so many things, then God himself also began to tell Satan something.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Today, I want you to be aware that whatever be the dirty clothes in your life, if you begin to pray and you make your mind to remove them, God will start answering your prayer.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Okay.
Now Joshua was dressed in the dirty clothes as he stood before the angel. The angel said to those who were standing before him, take off his dirty clothes. Then he said to Joshua, see, I have taken and away your sin, and I will put rich garment on you. But
hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bible says, after Joshua,
when Joshua began to pray, the devil told Joshua, you are wearing a dirty clothes. Why are you dirty and you are standing before God to pray?
Hallelujah.
Amen. My brothers and my sisters, I want to ask you this morning, what is the dirty clothes that you are wearing today that you pray to God and you don't get answer?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bible
says Joshua began to remove the clothes from himself.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Have you made your mind this morning to remove that dirty clothes that you are wearing today?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Emi anom yewo ejidifo bebre ewo wiase mu a.
Brothers and sisters, we have a lot of believers in this world.
Abreni abrebia wo ko asontem tie.
All the time they go to church.
Abreni abrebia wo bom pa ye tie.
All the time they pray.
Abreni abrebia wo tu ana mo tie.
All the time they
They're
trying to progress in Christian life.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So idea was an insight and an insight to me.
Whatever he deserves, he does not get it.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now every enemy,
It's because of certain things in his life, that's why he does not get whatever he deserves.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And Bible says, when Joshua was praying, God told Joshua, today I've removed that dirty cloth from you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Today, God is telling you, whatever thing that is entangling you in your life, God says he has taken it away from you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. If you only give your life to God, if you only rely on him, if you only come forward before him, whatever which is tying you up, God says he has removed it today.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Beautiful. Then he said, put the clean turban on his head. So they put the clean turban on his head and put him, while the angel of the Lord stand by. The angel of the Lord gave this charge to Joshua. This is what the Lord Almighty says. If you will walk in my ways and keep my requirement, then you will govern my house and have charge of my court, and I will give you a place among these standing here.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Bible say abra Joshua shasia wo wuru atade fini fini ne hono.
Bible says when Joshua removed the dirty clothes from himself,
Bible say when Yakobon shasia ede eche fufuro a eye enumonyam che ebe she Joshua biem.
Bible says God gave him a different clothes which is of more grace than the one that he was using before.
Hallelujah.
Na Bible say when Yakobon ka chere Joshua say be bi pia na wode ne nan besi no.
Bible said God told Joshua wherever he put his foot,
be bi pia na wo be ko no.
Wherever you go,
die wo be ye bia no.
Whatever you do,
and no more bia wo be to no.
Any step that you make,
so when you want to me so dia,
when you rely on me,
wo be din kunim,
you'll be victorious.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Today, if you only rely on God, today, if you are going to walk in God, if only you remove the dirty clothes you are wearing, all your endeavors will be victorious.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And of whom not Joshua, and yourself a penny.
Beloved, Joshua was a high priest. Why is that a high priest was wearing a dirty clothes? Ask yourself in your life. Today you are a believer. What are the things which are bind you in your life? What are the things that do not make you progress in your life? What are the things which have been tied that you are still sitting at one place?
Hallelujah.
Amen. Today, if you can only come step forward in the word of God, if you only allow the word of God be the king in your life, your life will be of victorious. Whatever you do will be victorious.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Joshua is of openly.
Joshua was a high priest. Today you are a believer.
What kind of abrabo we say? Me yechidini abrani abrabi. What kind of wasitremu?
All the time you say to people, or you say it in your life, you are a Christian.
So me yechidini diye.
I am a Christian.
Nansuni pa eta umwasi ane ewo niyembi o abrabo we say.
The people around you see so many things in your life that
You are not a believer because of the things that is going on in your life. People see that you are not a believer.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When I come across Joshua, some of us are tired of being
weary. Joshua, if you only remove this dirty clothes and then you walk in me,
you'll
be victorious. Today, if you also walk in the light of God, if you are only going to rely on God today, and today you are going to allow Jesus Christ to be your victorious, whatever you do, you will be victorious.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Pray for me. Continue.
That's it. Listen, O heart is Joshua, and your associates seated before you, who are men symbolic of things to come. I am going to bring a servant, the branch. See the stone I have set in front of Joshua. There are seven eyes on that one stone, and I will engrave an inscription on it. Save the Lord Almighty, and I will remove the sin of this land in the single day. In that day, each of you will invite his neighbor to sit under his vine and fiction. Declare the Lord Almighty. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Bible says Joshua. Say woman and two woman.
Bible says Joshua, if you only walk in me. If you will rely on me. If you remove that dirty clothes from you. I'll put in seven stones before you.
Jesus Christ.
That seven stones, Bible makes me understand that they stand for Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I'll put in some stones before you. That stone is where your victory comes from.
Hallelujah.
Amen. If you only rely on God Almighty, if you allow Jesus Christ to be the king of your life,
was it Joshua?
He said, Joshua, all the land before you, all the ones that your eyes see, I'll put it before you.
Now,
you'll be victorious over this land, and you will live on this land. On this land that all the group of people
and
all the group of families, they will all come and worship you. And you'll be very big head. And you'll bear a lot of fruits. And a lot of different kinds of people. And they will come and pluck some of the fruits.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If today you remove that dirty clothes,
Bible
says a group of people will come before you. And you bear fruit. And all people will come and pluck that fruit and eat.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The tree is a victory tree.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Mimi, any day, what person will swear by now?
My brothers and sisters, today, do you want to bear a fruit?
What person you papa will now see now?
Do you want people to come close to you? Do you want all people to run to you?
And you shall see now what I pray now.
Then begin to remove the clothes that is not good in your life. When you bring it to our daily lives, anyone who goes into public wearing dirty clothes, when you get into the gathering, people will start to draw away from him. na obi anso a okwe nipa do mu a wasiesie ne ho no
whoever goes into public with well dressed
abra obi nipa do mu no
the moment you get into the gathering
na obi a hyasee e pese wo ka kwa na
people will start drawing closer to you.
Oh hallelujah,
amen,
hallelujah.
Ebienti ena obi a wasiesie ne ho nipa nyina pese wo ka kwa sa nipa no.
Why is it that the person who have dressed very well, people want to draw closer to him or her? Because everybody likes that person. Everybody knows that when you draw closer to that person, you will not be dirty.
Hallelujah.
Amen. That is why everybody wants to draw closer to that person. If we will only remove athletic clothes, throw it away, God will make us victorious. Even though Joshua was wearing athletic clothes, when he removed it,
Bible says,
God made him a great person.
Now he
said, the land before you, I've given it to you. You will live on this land. And all people will come before you. And they will come and eat on your table.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Open your Bible, Isaiah. Chapter 6.
7-9
Isaiah
chapter 6 verse 7 and 9.
Continue. Isaiah.
He touched my mouth and said, see this, these are what you are lips. Your guilty is taken away and your sin atoned for. Then I hear the voice of the Lord saying, whom shall I send and who will go for us? And I said, here I am, send me. He said, go and tell these people, be ever hearing, but never understanding. Be ever seeing, but never receiving. Make the heart of these people close. Make their ears dull and close their eyes. Otherwise, they might see with their eyes, hear with their ears, understand with their heart.
Amen. God has taken all the sinful nature from you.
And I'm open and I would do a moon.
What do you want to do for God? What are you going to do for God?
What
he has given it to some people. But they did not see. He has opened the eyes of some people. But they can't see.
What can't you be known?
He told some people. But they don't understand. But you, God have saved you. God have saved you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
My brothers and sisters, there were so many things which is tying you. Somebody wants to be like you, but he can't get it. Why?
Because you
have seen a man.
You don't want to be maybe so.
You are relying on a certain man.
Be man in the mind.
Who is that man?
When it's Jesus.
It's Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bible says, why you not miss man?
Bible says, who should I send?
Now why never come?
And who will go?
Why not miss me one to the soul?
Who should I rely on?
Now why am I not miss me pray?
And whom shall my glory come out?
Hallelujah.
Amen. When God rely on you, His glory will come out or will be shown to others. It's you who can take a step forward for God Almighty.
When you come from fail,
God has called you.
Now when I'm here, I say
you were in the world.
Now we will go back and say
you were living your life as you like.
Yes, when you come from fail,
but now God has called you.
My
brothers and sisters, whatever that it means in your life today, I want you to throw all those kind of things away. So that God can send you. So that God can use you. So that God will glorify Himself in your life.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Open your Bible, Matthew 13, 11 to 15.
Matthew chapter 13, verse 11 to 15.
15. Matthew 13, 11.
Matthew chapter 13, verse 11.
The knowledge of the secret of the kingdom of heaven has been given to you, but not to them. Whoever has gone to even more, and he will have an abundance. Whoever does not have even what he has will be taken from him. This is why I speak to them in parable. Thought seeing, you do not see. Thought hearing, you do not hear or understand. In them is fulfilled the prophecy of Isaiah. You will be ever hearing but never understanding. You will be ever seeing but never receiving. This people has become blind. They hardly hear with their ears and they have closed their eyes. Otherwise, they might see with their eyes, hear with their ears, understand with their heart and think, and I will heal them.
Hallelujah.
Bible says God has given to you.
You,
God have saved you. Joshua was a high priest. When he went before God, God saved him. You also, when you come before God, today God has saved you. Today God has removed all the dirty things in your life. He said He has given to some people, but they did not see. He has opened the eyes of some people, but their eyes did not see it. He has opened the ears of others, but they did not hear.
But
you, God has made you understand. Whenever he speaks in parables.
Now
but you,
what can I be born?
When he speaks in parables,
what he has here,
you do understand.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Many are tarifi bene show.
My brothers and sisters, what are the dirty clothes that you are wearing?
And you may feel bene show.
What are the clothes which are dirty you are wearing?
Was see what they are poor and so yes,
he said he has put in 7 stones before you.
Says
upon that stones, that's where your victory comes from. Are you going to stand upon those stones or you're going to stand beside the stones?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Today, if you stand on that stones, you're going to be victorious. If you stand beside it in your life, there will be difficulties every day and then.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you uncouple see any day, what you are poor as you anymore. Now so who be chinasua will be young could be for
God says he has put in stones before you. If you stand on it, you'll be victorious.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
What's what can what Isaiah woman?
He has said it in Isaiah. That they will give birth a man on this earth.
Now he will ever then a better so
he will be king of kings.
Now he will ever then a better so
his kingdom will be on his shoulders.
Hallelujah.
Now you're not afraid of him.
And his name will be called Wonderful.
Danger!
That's what I'm talking. He will be called Forever Father.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You have any danger?
We hope.
Over 2-4.
Cancer. Advisor. In fact, he's going to keep.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You have been through for
2-4.
As you do here,
we will call him counselor.
As you do here,
peace.
Danger.
Forever Father.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And yes, amen. Because he is the one coming to this world to come and save us from our sins. He is coming to this world to take us from our bad attitude and situation.
Isaiah
has already said so many things about him. And when he came into this world, whoever relied on him, he was not displeased.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when you want to destroy,
when you rely on him, you will never be disgraced.
So when you do what you want, when you move away,
if you walk in him, you will never be disgraced.
So when you let him in, I will be upon you when you move away.
If you allow him to be the king of your life, you will never be disgraced.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And let the woman let him in, I will be upon
you. Today, are you allowing him to be the king of your life?
And then there will be so small prayer for what